Welcome to the Hydraulic Press channel. Today we have really interesting video. How many soda cans can you fit in one Pringles can? Because these go like this here, nicely. Two of those. But the third one is sticking out. But if you crush them in, how many is going to go there? And I made this. It's Pringles can 5 million. We are going to crush the cans there, and then we are going to push the block out and place it inside of the Pringles can. And without the press, 2 fits. And if it's completely solid block of aluminium, the volume of the can could fit about 300. So I would say that we can fit at least 100 there. That's my goal. And you can write your own quest down in the comments. And yeah, I just start to pile up the cans there and crush them. And Anni is going to count how many there is. Okay, so we are ready to start. And our idea is to do sets of 10. And we are going to count them with these. So we are going to be able to count it really well. Yeah, here it goes. This is going to take forever. It's going to be so long day. Hey. 3 done, and like 97 left. Ugh. This is going to take so long. Okay, 60 cans have gone in, and I think we are almost halfway. And I have been using very little force because of safety reasons. But now I want to try, will it go like any tighter if I increase the pressure? So I'm going to increase the pressure, and we are going to go behind the blast screen in case it goes bad. I'm not going to use much more, like maybe 50 bar. I think that's enough. Yeah, it didn't affect much, maybe like a couple millimeters. So we are going to continue with the low pressure, and then we are going to finish it off when it's like about full. Hey, it's 100 cans in there, and I'm going to now make them again a little bit tighter. Okay, it went like 5 millimeters down, and now we can actually do comparison. Here is the level of the cans. And here is Pringles can. So not much more to go. Okay, 120 cans. Now we are over that I expected that it's possible to fit there. And I think I'm going to price the pressure. And I'm going to crush with about 70 tons for a long time to get all air and water out from the aluminium. And then we are going to see, do we have any more space? Is there some gear sound?
I don't hear.
I think that's pretty cool. Okay, I didn't expect that we actually broke the tool, but it came loose from the welds, because in theory, all the force that I apply here should just go through the aluminium pancake to this, and there shouldn't be any force lifting the pipe up. But that didn't happen, and this broke. But we have only like 2 centimeters more room, and I think this might expand a little bit when we take it out from the pipe. So I think this is pretty good spot to end this. And now we have, this is like pretty good situation here, but we need to move them to Pringles can, otherwise there isn't any point on this. So I'm going to get some suitable tools here, and then we are going to push everything out from here under the table, and then it's done. Okay, so now I have this here, and there is a hole in the middle of that that is large enough for the cans. So here we go. Now we just hope that they are in one piece. But that doesn't matter, we can still put them in the Pringles can. And then I'm going to lift this up. And then we have to, only one step left. Hey, last cans! Hey, how nice is that? Here it is! It's completely full. 120 cans. I have to say that if you would make like steel container around the Pringles can, and did everything perfectly, I would say that you could fit maybe 20 or 30 more. That's like absolute maximum that you can do. But 120 is pretty goddamn good. Okay, and now we are going to weigh the can with the cans. It's 1.56 kilograms. So is it like 3 pounds or 4 or something like that? Yeah, if you have other ideas like this, please let us know. And that is all for today. Thank you for watching and have a nice day. And for today's extra content, we have this cucumber moped. It looks really harmless, but it can run over you at any moment, so we have to deal with it.